Hi, everybody. Al Bernstein for the Boxing Channel here with Angel Heredia, who is the strength and conditioning coach for Juan Manuel Marquez. And at this press conference for the Bradley fight, you got up and you talked about the elephant in the room that people have accused Juan Manuel Marquez of using performance-enhancing drugs. You've been working with him, and you talked about your compliance with the Nevada Commission.
That's correct. I stood up and talked about it because Fernando Beltran, who's a promoter for Juan Manuel Marquez, stated clearly there was a lot of controversy in the past because of testing. And the Nevada State Commission now is been doing a great job. I think it'll be the first movement for any commission to follow up. And hopefully this will be a positive movement for any boxer to get involved in properly testing with blood and urine. And I had to, you know, come up and say it publicly because, you know, I've been accused, I've been attacked most of the time by the media, by the fans. Not everyone, but, you know, it's better for me to say it because a lot of people get confused. Once again, Juan Manuel Marquez is getting tested blood and urine. Bradley, it is the same, but it's all WADA compliant. WADA is the maximum testing authority that is in the world. There's no other association or any other testing agency that is superior to them. So just wanted to clear up the point. That's all. You know, I just want to make sure that I said it. Bob Arum said it. Beltran said it. So we just want to make sure that there's no misunderstandings. There's a lot of people in the media that has been misleading everyone, and I just want to make sure that I don't want you guys to get misled on that.
Mm-hmm. Now, so, okay, and Juan Manuel Marquez has physically looked a little different. He's been, he appears stronger. So that comes from what?
We're working, as I told everyone, you know, for example, with Pacquiao, we needed to have the power for the KO. The KO was something we had to work on. It happened. Now Bradley, obviously, he's fast. He moves quick. I want Marquez to be quick, but, you know, he's still strong. He's very strong, but he's quicker now. So it's going to be a fight that is going to require speed versus speed. Mm-hmm. So how you neutralize speed? With speed. But obviously, Juan Manuel Marquez is a very smart fighter. Then we will be working on a different training, but more into focusing on that area.
So really, for the Pacquiao fight, there was this effort to create a lot of strength, which meant certain kinds of body mass, and that's part of the reason you're saying why he appeared to be stronger.
That's correct. When I started training, Marquez was in the third fight. I feel we won the fight. The decision went the other way around. We were pretty fast, we were strong. But this time, on the fourth fight, Marquez, Nacho, myself, my father here, we all wanted to have a KO. That was the only thing we could overpass the any judge's decision. So we work on the knockout. Marquez, obviously, anybody who's in strength conditioning knows that when you get mass, you get stronger, you can sacrifice a little bit of speed, though. But the power is what the last alternative you have to provide the punch and power. And that's what we needed. So, you know, Marquez was going for the KO. Pacquiao even was for the KO. It was a war. So this fight might go to distance, might go 1-on-1, who knows. But I want to make sure Marquez is covered. All the different angles, you know.
All right. Thank you for visiting with us.
Anytime.
All right. Angel Heredia, who here at the press conference talked about the question about PEDs, and we had a chance to chat with him right now. Stay with us for coverage all week here on the Boxing Channel.